had it under control. Right up until the moment I didn't. I'll do better next time. I knew you'd turn up sooner or later, but I had been hoping for sooner. How are you? We've fought them to a standstill then. The Exarch did say that the Empire seemed to have drawn back when he last looked in on the source. But without knowing for sure how fast time was passing there, I couldn't help worrying that a lot might have happened since then. I'm heartily relieved to hear that it hasn't, just as Alphano must have been. As you can imagine, both he and Urianger were desperate to hear the news from home when I arrived. I haven't actually seen Thancred and Yshtola yet, but they will have heard all the latest developments from the Exarch by now, or should have at least. When I think of how frantic Tataru and the others must be, I want nothing more than to rush back and reassure them. But we still haven't found a way to reverse the summoning, and even if we had, we couldn't just ignore Urielje's vision. He may use 10 words where one would suffice, and they may often obscure as much as they reveal. But on this matter, he was as clear as day. I do not doubt for one moment that he saw what he claims. Nor how difficult it must have been to speak about them. The 8th Umbral Calamity and your death aren't exactly topics for idle conversation. As much as I might want to go home, I don't want to go home to that. We can't allow the rejoining to happen, which means we have to save the First from the Sin Eaters. That great wall of white is a remnant of the Flood. 100 years ago, the balance in the First tipped decisively in favor of light. From that moment, it rose and swelled with each passing day, and then, without warning, it burst forth like water from a broken dam. A colossal wave of pure light, drowning everything in its wake. Only Norvrant was spared. For the most part, living things are composed of ether of various different aspects. But when exposed to such a flood, their etheric harmony is shattered, and their natural form breaks down. Then they either perish, or are warped into mindless abominations. Yes, that's how the Sin Eaters came to be. They were once living creatures, or people, that were caught in the path of the Flood. Once the change is wrought, there is no going back. In that instant, they are gripped by an insatiable appetite for ether, and will happily gorge themselves on any living thing within reach. But even that is not the worst of it. The stronger Sin Eaters can plant light in us, like seeds in soil, corrupting our ether and triggering the birth of new monstrosities. They are creatures of base instinct that exist only to feed and to multiply. They feel no pity, know no remorse, and are utterly deaf to reason. Which is why they must be destroyed. Every last one of them. The infirmary is full of the Sin Eaters' victims, left here to spend their final hours waiting for the change to overtake them. Over there, where the wall is broken. Do you see what lies beyond? That's what the land became after the light flooded in. An empty, white nothingness. Life cannot exist in such conditions. The primordial light would wreak havoc on the body's etheric balance. That nectarine you bought, it's Halric's favorite fruit. Most of the patients, Halric included, survived the attacks of powerful eaters. But their fate was sealed all the same. The monster's corruption has entered their bodies, and their very essence is being subsumed by light. The twisted state of the world itself just makes matters worse. Under normal circumstances, a person's ether naturally tends to equilibrium. But for these poor souls, the opposite is true. Sooner or later, every single one of them will turn. Tesleen and the patients, they all know this. They know what has to be done before the change goes too far, before the eater within takes over. The preferred method is mixing poison into their favorite food. In my time here, I've borne witness to a lot of last meals. I feel just as helpless as before. No matter how hard I fight, it's never enough. But it's a war I mean to wage, nonetheless. Speaking of wars, do you remember how I made you promise not to leave me and then promptly collapsed? Well, let's just say I had a few choice words for the Exarch concerning the timing of his summons. But even if the fault lay with someone else, I couldn't shake the feeling that I'd abandon you on the battlefield. So I swore that I'd make up for my absence there by making a difference here. And that's what keeps me moving forward, even when things seem hopeless. On which note, it's time we headed back. The longer we keep Tesleen waiting, the harder this will be for her.
wake up if you'd like another helping. I made a little bit more than usual today.
And you've added something special to the broth, if I'm not mistaken.
Aye, well, it's not often we have visitors from the Crystarium, so I may have thrown in a few extra bits and bobs. That's what I like to hear. Give me a moment to warm up the pot. In a place like this, you learn to take what moments of happiness you can get. I remember when I first came here with my mother. She was showing the early signs. I knew there was no way to save her, but I just couldn't face what needed to be done. That's the way of it for most people. Why they travel from arms to stay here. Beaten, broken souls come to wait out the inevitable, to receive the mercy of a painless death. When my mother finally left this world, I was mad with grief, but also thankful that her passing was a peaceful one. It's never easy ending a life you've cared for, even when you believe they go on to a better place. I often find myself wishing the Warrior of Darkness would come and do that part for me.
The Warrior of Darkness?
You've never heard the tale? I'm not sure where it began, but every child in Norvrent could tell you a version of it. Warrior of Darkness, servant of death, take care of our souls at our dying breath. Let sinners and eaters of sin go with thee, that all may return to the sunless sea. Well, that's the version I was taught anyway. It's just an old bedtime story. He certainly never deigned to visit us here.
Which is a good thing, surely. He sounds rather ominous.
Do you think so? I always liked the idea that he treated every soul the same, even the Sin Eaters.
They're coming.
Have you seen Halric? I swear, I only took my eyes off him for a moment.
Any sign of him? No luck then. But he surely can't have gone far. We should keep looking. The Sin Eaters are out in force, and if we don't find him soon, you can be sure they will. Did you see the size of that thing? It must be one of the nasty ones. Wherever it's going, it can only mean trouble. After it!
Deserve happiness, wherever we can find it. The time left to you is precious. No one should die in vain. Mother, I...